When people think of gout, the thought of a hot, painful, and acutely swollen joint come to mind. However, that is only the tip of the iceberg, and there is more to this disease than meets the eye. If left untreated, gout can become a chronic disease, causing multiple complications. The stages of gout. Acute gout, or a gout attack, happens when something causes the uric acid levels to either go up or down abruptly. For example, a large purine load, like an alcohol binge. This causes disturbance of the uric acid crystals that have formed in the joint. Uric acid is seen by the body as an outsider, and therefore, the body will try and attack this, leading to inflammation. This can be a highly inflammatory state, and therefore, attacks can be excruciatingly painful, with redness, heat, and swelling, leading to inability to use the joint properly. If untreated, these attacks are self-limiting and will subside after a few days on its own. 60% of people who have a gout attack will have a second one within a year. And overall, 84% may have another attack within 3 years if not controlled. Interval gout, or intercritical gout, is the time between these attacks. There is no pain or joint swelling, but this does not mean that the gout is gone. If nothing is done to try and decrease the uric acid levels during this time, the uric acid crystals continue to deposit in various joints and tissues and can lead to damage. This is an opportunity to start management via lifestyle changes and possibly medication to prevent future attacks or chronic gout. Chronic gout develops in patients with gout whose uric acid levels remain high. When uric acid levels in the bloodstream remain too high, more and more crystals are deposited. Acute attacks become more frequent and more severe. Joint damage occurs, which can lead to a loss of mobility. Chronic gout can present with one or more of the following. Tophi. When uric acid crystals begin to deposit in soft tissue, they form nodules called tophi. Tophi commonly appear in the hands, fingers, elbows, and ears, but they can appear almost anywhere in the body, which can be very disfiguring. Progression of flares can also occur. As chronic gout gets worse, flare-ups occur more often and last longer. In about half of all patients with gout, the first attack occurs in the joint at the base of the big toe. When chronic gout occurs, other joints may be affected, including the ankle and the knee. Over time, the inflammation causes permanent damage to bone and cartilage, which we call as erosions, and these can lead to functional disability. Uric acid is normally eliminated by the kidneys. Kidney disease, therefore, can cause uric acid to build up and lead to gout. However, excess uric acid can also damage the kidneys. And so kidney problems associated with chronic gout include a gouty kidney, kidney stones, and kidney failure. Although one can easily forget they have gout after an attack resolves, it is important to realize that the problem can still persist and move into a chronic phase with more complications, as we mentioned above. Therefore, prevention and early treatment, if indicated, are ways to get this disease under control.